My name is Carol Nagar. I am a writer and photography historian, and I've been working on a biography of Chim, and I've been recently publishing a book, Chim, Children of War. In April of 1948, he was hired by UNESCO to do a reportage on Europe's children and the role of UNICEF in helping out the 13 million children who had been victims of war. And he traveled for several months and he shot 257 rolls of film. I wanted to, for a very long time, to do a book about these children. I went back to the contact sheet and I saw that there was a huge amount of material that had not been used in his original 1949 Children of Europe book that was published by UNESCO. Like, for instance, this image of poor Naples children posing in front of a street photographer's background, that is an image of courtly children wearing rich clothes, which appeals to my sense of humor and Chim's sense of humor, obviously. I think that Chim really embodies this principle of no children being the enemy. Even though his family had been killed by the Nazi, he knew that the civilian population was basically victims, and he focused on that. One of the photographs was taken near the Krupp factories, and you could see in the background these huge chimneys that are belching black smoke. And there's a lot of debris, there's a lot of ruins, and in the foreground there's a baby, and the contrast is so strong that it almost looks like a photo montage. And the other image was taken at the Brandenburg Gate. There is this carriage on the top of the gate where the wings of the angels are broken, and there's this man pushing a sort of makeshift pram with one of his children standing in it and the other walking in front. In Poland, Chim went to several places. One of them was a school for mentally disturbed children. Their teachers had asked them to draw images of their houses. He came upon a little girl, Tereshka, and she's standing in front of the board. And she is incapable of drawing. All she can do is a scroll. It's a sort of a maelstrom of feeling. This chalk drawing is incredible. It looks like a scribbled nest, and the image of her face is really unforgettable. It has come to symbolize fear and trauma. Chim also went to the only structure that was not destroyed in the Warsaw ghetto, that was a field of ruins. He climbed on a hill and he did a sort of a bird's eye view of children walking towards the high school in their uniforms. And he also posed them as if in a family portrait near pieces of ruins where they were climbing. And one really strong part of these photographs is in the background, there is a church, St. Augustine, and it turns out that this church, which is also still standing, is in the very street where he had lived and where his father had his publishing house before the war. You can only imagine the emotions as he did these pictures, because in a way he was also a survivor. In the high schools, he focused on the reconstruction efforts as the boys and the girls were doing science projects, but they had to improvise, there was no equipment. So they used ink bottles, they used cans. So he did not only represent the children as victims, he saw them as active agents in their own recovery. In Italy, I think some of his most striking photographs were taken either in the streets of Naples, where he photographed Angela, a little girl who sold black market cigarettes to sailors. After Naples, he also went to Rome and he photographed in an orphanage where a lot of kids had lost limbs. He photographed them playing ball because it was thought that they should exercise whatever muscles they had left. And then he came upon a boy who had lost both arms during the war and who was blind. And there is this close-up of the boy whose face is completely on the book, reading the braille with his lips. To me, it's almost as a prayer. And there's always this feeling that he believes that the act of reading, the act of learning, is a sort of a redemption. There is a wonderful photograph where you see a little Greek island, and the only child left there is Eleftheria, who is, I believe, a four-year-old and lives with her grandmother. Chim has brought her a pair of shoes, so you could see the girl staring at the shoes, and her face is pure joy. His photographs have strength and a sort of freshness or naivete, maybe, or purity of spirit. There is definitely a very strong emotional link. He appealed to that part of being children that remains in all of us. And this is why we are touched. And I think that is why we are still touched by his images.